BioLab29 here, and this is BioLiving Organics. So here we are, mid-October. We have three plants left. As you can see, the capstone is starting to fade and she's ripening up really, really nice. Gives you an idea of her tops. They're not as long as the dozy doe, but they're very, very nice in their own right. Maybe not as dense either, but close to it. So there's just starting to be a few amber trichomes showing up on the capstone. Now the romulan, we're gonna take this down today. We were saying we were gonna take it down a week ago, but we let it go another week in spite of the spider mites. And she did ripen up a little bit more. The buds are still pretty fluffy, but I think she's gonna be some good smoke. And our third plant, of course, is the chili verde. But before we go over to the chili verde, we'll take a look at a few more buds. And it's very early in the morning, just after 9 o'clock. And of course, indoors, you can give your plants a extended period of darkness, but you can't do that outdoors. And the best thing to do is to harvest your plants in the morning. So as you can see, the tops are very nice size on the romulan. She's falling over, and this lady is coming down.
So fast forward to the future, and what we are doing here is a bud wash. So we've taken down about half the romulan, and now we have three buckets. One bucket has hydrogen peroxide, and what we do is we dunk into each bucket, agitate, and we want to just shake off any bugs. And the higher pH of the water with the addition of the baking soda, excuse me, this is baking soda in this bucket, that's supposed to make the bugs jump off. The next bucket has hydrogen peroxide and lemon juice. And we have half a lemon juice, the juice of half a lemon, it's a better way to say that. And we also have 7 tablespoons of hydrogen peroxide in this 5-gallon bucket. And we have them filled up to 5 gallons of water. And then our last bucket is just pure filtered water. Give the buds a nice rinse, and from there we go right onto our drying rack. And the final process is
We will put fans going all around this structure, which will contain all the branches, and we'll dry them off manually, and then we'll hang them up to finish their dry. The key is to get all of this moisture off the buds so they don't form any mold. And that is your bud wash procedure. Remember, the first bucket is baking soda, and that's 1 gram per liter of water. And we basically put 2 tablespoons in this 5 gallon bucket of water. We have half a lemon, and we have 7 tablespoons of hydrogen peroxide in this bucket, and this bucket is pure filtered water. And that is the bud washing procedure. And here we go. This is Noam Chomsky, and he's getting lit. So we'll be back. And our final lady, she'll probably be the last one to come down also, is the Chili Verde. As you can see, the sun is still at a low angle, causing a lot of shadow. The Chili Verde has some nice colors. It's got some purples in it. I'd say she has a little bit more to go though. Very close. So, about a little over a month ago, we did release some green lacings. We released the larva, and although we did continue to spray after we saw that they really weren't putting that much of a dent in the population of spider mites, we did start to spray. But the other day we did see a couple of green lacewing adults in the shelter. So I don't see them right now. They're probably foraging somewhere. Because if they survived this long, they've had to have eaten something. So this is just a short update before we go into trim gel. It's been a long outdoor season, as usual. That's the thing about outdoors, it's a long grow season, and there's a lot of factors involved. Weather permitting is the rule, and the weather can have a profound effect on the quality of your harvest and whether you're going to harvest at all. Because rain and humidity can destroy a harvest. They can destroy your crop. Yes, those factors can destroy your crop. And of course, you have insects. You get things that you wouldn't even get indoors. Generally, you would never see caterpillars indoors. But of course, as all of us outdoor growers know, cats are a big issue when you're growing outdoors. That's why we have this shelter up. This screen shelter is specifically to protect the plants from caterpillars. And it worked very, very well. We haven't found one caterpillar on any plant so far, on everything that we've taken down already, and on the plants that are still up. And the beauty of this greenhouse is, of course, you have full UV exposure and you have a nice airflow. You really don't have to worry about the humidity unless the humidity outdoors is very, very high. And it has been pretty high recently, but it's tapering back down. So we'll probably be able to finish these two ladies off, the Capstone and the Chili Verde, with no issues. And we'll keep our fingers crossed for that, because it's day to day when you're outdoors. So another one bites the dust in the garden. So that's all we have for you today. Like, comment, and subscribe. This is BioLiving Organics, and I'm BioBuzz29, and I'm out.